Wish you all a happy and healthy 2016. 2015 is leaving with a lesson to us that markets are unpredictable. We were convinced that interest rates will come down at the beginning of 2015. The RBI did cut interest rates by 125 basis points. However, the market yields declined by just 10 basis points in 2015, giving bulk of the return in fixed income funds by way of coupon income rather than capital appreciation. In equity markets, we expected that equities will deliver good return. For the first few months of 2015, markets went up, but in the second half of 2015, it went down and generated a negative return on broad indices. Our funds delivered 4 to 8% outperformance over benchmark indices, yet they fell below expected return of the investors. Clearly, markets are unpredictable. And with that caveat, we are talking about what will be the shape of future in 2016. From a global point of view, we are seeing US Fed raising interest rates in December 2015 after a gap of almost 10 years. We believe as long as the pace of rate hike by US is as per the expectation of the market, then this is well discounted into our debt and equity markets. Unless Fed raises the pace of rate hike, which is extremely unlikely, this will provide an opportunity to enter into market if any of our markets correct because of the Fed rate hike. China is clearly the country to watch for. Whenever China will get cold, we'll start sneezing. China represents 10% of global GDP, but dominates commodity markets between 30 to 50% consumer share. Clearly, Chinese slowdown will have repercussions on India in the form of dumping by Chinese companies in India, in the form of lower commodity prices. Let's watch China carefully as it's going to impact our market. Indian currency will have to pass September 2016 litmus test. We have to repay about $36 billion of FCNRB deposits, which we raised in September 2013. We have adequate reserves to repay our FCNRB deposit obligation. However, such a large outflow could have impact on fixed income market as well as equity market. The FIIs have been net buyers of Indian equities to the extent of about $3 billion in calendar year 2015. However, this number do not highlight that India-dedicated ETFs and India-dedicated funds kept on receiving flows into them. Bulk of the investment happened in the first half of calendar year 2015. And in the second half, we actually witnessed redemptions or selling by the FII investors. Bulk of the selling was done by global emerging market funds who were reducing their over-allocation to India. Some of the selling was even done by the pension fund. Contrary to popular expectation, sovereign funds have actually increased their allocation to India as reflected in NSDL data. The domestic investors have been supportive of Indian equity market. In calendar year 2015, we saw more than 72,000 crore worth of investments by domestic mutual funds. This is a very, very rare event. In last 24 months, we have collected more money in equity mutual funds than what we had collected in previous 10 years as an industry. Certainly, these flows haven't received as much expected return as they were expecting earlier. Certainly, these flows haven't received as much return as they were expecting when making investment. We owe responsibility to them to engage and ensure that they remain committed and invested into equity fund so that eventually they have a pleasant experience. In calendar year 2015, Indian economy suffered certain setbacks. The rural economy was under stress because of two consecutive below average monsoon. The private sector investment remained under stress because of many leverage bets taken in the past did not work out for the entrepreneurs. The exports were under pressure because of relative appreciation of rupee vis-a-vis other emerging market currency. This rural stress, lack of private sector investment and export created pressure on the economy, even though government spending was trying to keep the economy on the forefront. In calendar year 2016, we believe we have better opportunity on all three counts. India has never suffered three consecutive below average monsoon. Hopefully this year we will not create that record. Augmentation of conditions which are favorable for El Nino also gives confidence that next year's monsoon should be good. This will be positive for rural economy. Rupee, while has remained remarkably stable, hopefully will give more breathing space to exporters compared to last year, and export should start recovering. The private sector investment revival will be function of government spending, which courtesy the oil price correction is on the upswing, and we will see benefit of government spending of calendar year 2015 as well as 2016 eventually reflecting into private sector revival. We believe in calendar year 2016, if we cut interest rates at the borrower's level, if we revive exports, if monsoon is good supporting rural economy, and if government continues its spend on infrastructure like it is doing in previous year, then we have better chances of corporate earnings revival. Today, Nifty is trading at about 15.5 times FY 2017 earning. This is assuming a very, very moderate earnings growth of about 15%. Today, mid-caps are trading at about 10% premium to large-caps. The equity markets will have to watch out for certain events in calendar year 2016. The first event to watch out for will be budget. In FY16 budget, we have given fiscal deficit target of 3.5% for FY17 and 3% for FY2018. This year, the government has to accommodate 7th pay commission recommendation, which releases about 100,000 crore in the pockets of more than 1 crore central government employees and pensioners. Certainly, how does government balance between 7th pay commission recommendation vis-a-vis fiscal deficit target will determine how equity markets behave. We have seen in the past that whenever we have brought our deficit under control, it has resulted into higher equity valuation. The market will then be looking forward to monsoon. Hopefully, La Nina will give positive monsoon to us. We will not create the hat trick of a three consecutive below average monsoon. The market will then be looking forward to September 2016, where we have to repay $36 billion worth of FCNRB deposits. But most important within all this thing is the corporate earning revival. The December 2015 quarterly results and March 2016 quarterly results, by virtue of lower base last year, will provide some optical illusion that corporate earnings are recovering. It is important for us to see in subsequent quarters earnings actually picking up on back of interest rate cut, on back of export revival, on back of good monsoon, and on back of government spending rejuvenating Indian economy. If the government can pass certain bills which are supportive for economic reforms like land acquisition bill, labor reform bill, goods and services tax bill, then the sentiments will be even better and it will be more supportive for the market. Calendar year 2015 was a year of stock picking. Even in a simple sector like banking and financial services, where everyone's business is borrowing and lending, we saw wide divergence in performance. Most PSU banks delivered negative return. Corporate-focused private sector also joined them. Retail-focused private sector banks delivered positive return. With that caveat that stock selection will be critical, in 2016, we see certain themes playing out. The first theme is related to urban consumption. The 7th pay commission will put about 100,000 crore in the hands of government employees and pensioners. After paying tax of about 25,000 crore, they will spend balance 75,000 crore on two-wheelers, four-wheelers, consumer durables, white goods, affordable housing EMIs, and so on and so forth. All companies which are related to this sectors should benefit from volume expansion. The other theme which will work out is related to public spending. Clearly today, private sector investment is on the back foot, and the government is taking the lead in spending money across sectors like road, railway, defense, mining. All the companies which are non-leveraged or reasonably leveraged and are participating in these sectors of road, railway, defense and mining should be benefiting from the public spending. The dark horse for calendar year 2016 will be rural consumption and rural economy related industries. Last 2 years below average monsoon has resulted into this companies coming under pressure. Assuming that the next year's monsoon will be normal, these companies will get a good breathing space and they should be able to deliver good performance. At Kotak Mutual Fund, we have been managing funds like our kids. We have very few funds. In each category, we have just one representative fund. So for large cap equity, we have Kotak 50. For multi cap equity, we have Kotak Select Focus. For small and mid cap category, we have Kotak Emerging Equity. The idea is to manage few funds so that our fund's performance and your client's return is similar compared to strategies followed by many of my peers where they have multiple funds and you will never know which fund will deliver better return. The other interesting step which we have taken at Kotak Mutual Fund is that myself and my colleagues have taken a pledge to invest all our money in Kotak Mutual Fund schemes whenever we are looking to invest in mutual funds. This is to ensure that your interest, your client's interest and our interest is aligned. This is to give you confidence that we are practicing what we are preaching. We recommend you to invest via systematic investment if you are a passive investor, or invest via asset allocation strategy if you are an active investor. Calendar year 2016, like in 2015 and before, will provide enough opportunity from a volatility point of view. Make this volatility your friend by buying on dips and keeping faith on India growth story. In calendar year 2015, with your support, Kotak Mutual Fund became one of the fastest growing asset management company in India. We look forward to your support for calendar year 2016 and beyond. We are thankful for your support and encouragement. We wish you very happy investing with Kotak Mutual Fund.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.